Christ is risen. Hallelujah. Dear sisters and brothers in Christ, this year's Easter comes at a time of a global pandemic that has caused and continues to cause so much pain and suffering. This pandemic has thrown the entire world into fears, anxiety, and uncertainties. So this morning, I want to begin by paying a special tribute to all those who are in the forefront in the fight against this pandemic, especially health workers that risk their lives in order to save others. Already, as we hear, some of them have paid the ultimate sacrifice in this service. We thank God for their courage and sacrifice. My heart and prayers go to various states of Nigeria and other parts of the world that are hit the most by this virus. When we hear from countries like the US, where about 2,000 people die in a day, this virus is certainly a very deadly and frightening thing. We remember those who have died and pray that God will console their loved ones. And we pray for the healing of those who have been affected. And what we Christi na kamu ku gai swaka ista awanda mudi miyarana rana kapani tiki gaduka kikrisia adunia. Banamu na ye wanda mkidi aloka chinda jamaa kuka mungu wa waku sabili da wana anoba wanda mudi gaya mungsani. Wana anoba ya jao wahala, ya jao bakitiki, ya jao damua bewa. For Musan, they need a go better to Zara. Somebody asked about the Zarafi, Kansur Para, the Dawkan Zarafi, Musaman, the Inkodia, the Allah, Sakiri, the Wat and the Sukha, the Haikan, Suna Aiki, Domikao, Kashem, Wendan, and Oba. Musaman, my Katan Asbiki, Wat and the Chicken, Idimansi, Yazama Goles, Kusakusa, the Wat and the Wendan and Oba, Yari Gayasha. Wannan ba kani aiki ne suke yi ba kuma mi kauya da suke yi ina addu'a musamman domin jihohin mu a nan Najeriya da kuma kasashen duniya inda wannan annoba ta riga ta yi nisa mutane da yawa suka rasa rayukansu. Una tuna wada wada masuka ilia sakara sumu na adua kuma domi niyalansu. Una adua domi ala itaosoki na wada masuka ipama ya chimta. Na Nigeria mungu la bayi ya zungu che ya bayi karibuku. Wada nanduka ya mungu wane una tuna wada sumu na adua domi ya mwazi. Dear friends, the fight against this virus must be won. It is a battle that humanity must win, and we shall win. So let us come together in faith and call upon God in prayers for His divine intervention. We need to unleash all our spiritual resources and on our knees call upon God for God to have mercy on His creation. And our prayers will never go in vain. At the same time, it is very critical that we take a stand together in common agreement as human family to fight this virus. It is important, therefore, that governments and citizens alike that we work together in order to halt its spread. I want to mention here particularly that it is important that we listen to the governments regarding restrictions and other directions that have been given, especially in order for us to be sure that we don't enhance the spread of this virus.
There is no doubt that those who have to struggle daily for their livelihoods, this is not an easy thing. It is not an easy thing for those who have to fend for their lives daily, truck pushers, those selling water, those selling food, women and men who have to run in the streets every day to fend for their livelihoods. There is no doubt that this is not easy. But it is necessary. It is necessary that we do all we can to lock down the virus before it locks us up all. Therefore, let us do whatever we can together in order to ease the suffering. I want to particularly appreciate the initiatives of our government at the federal and state levels with the support of donors, individuals and institutions in order to alleviate the suffering of the nurses, those most disadvantaged in our society. They need all the support they can get in order to sustain their lives and their families. My call therefore in this regard is for governments at the federal and state level and local level and even institutions, religious organizations, to ensure that this palliative care is done with fairness in a way that we should ensure that those who need it the most actually get it. I would like to appeal that this doesn't become a way for some individuals to enrich themselves. This will be tantamount to committing suicide. When brothers and sisters are dying of hunger, there's no reason for anybody to hold what has been released by the government or by individuals to assist. If there is any time we need each other, we need to stand to support the poorest of the poor in society, this is the time. This is the time we show the best part of humanity. And what in Christi, Wanan Kokornaya Sakota Wanan Anova, Dole de Koi, Dole de Adam Yasara Kasa. Tunda Hakale, Yazanale, Kuwa Nemu, we are in the Mukia, Dominu Hagi Adosa. Yazan Gore Muhaya Kai, the Kasakuni, the Gomati, the Kumasu Gabani, Abisa. Umuni the city bam. When they have the Nissan the Juna, when they have the Reggae Dua Haiti, when they have the Zama Adida, the Desawans, Wanan, Bam, Musa, Ineba, Musaman, what and they have to go to Kudum, to Jesu, 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 to Jesu,
we have a responsibility to reach out to our members
wherever they are, especially those who are just by themselves.
While addressing the pandemic, we must keep in mind also that our country is really very sick. Efforts in order to build a nation where peace and justice reigns must never be ignored. Efforts at securing lives and livelihoods must be sustained, including tackling terrorism, violence, kidnapping for the sake of money and for the sake of rituals, violent attacks and destructions and murders, cultism and the like. We must never ignore these atrocities in the society. Awana lokaci da ya zama dole mu yi nisa da juna, wayansu lokacai ma gwamnati za ta ba da umarni mu zauna a gida. A wannan lokaci ina kira ga iyalai mu kula da juna. Muna samun labari cewa wannan lokaci da ya zama dole ma'aurata suna gida ya kan kai wani lokaci maimakon ya zama lokaci da za mu rungumi juna ya kan kai saɓani mai yawa. Muna roƙo a yi haƙuri da juna a kuma kula da yara waɗanda yanzu ya zama dole suna makaranta. Ina kira ga pastoci ne da shugabannin ecclesia a sa hankali ga waɗanda suka kasa da waɗanda ba su da wani mai lura da su. A cikin hidimominmu mu tabbata mun kula da irin waɗannan. Biye da wannan, yayin da muke fama da cutar corona, kada mu manta ko kusa da waɗansu abubuwa da muke fama da su a ƙasar nan. Abun tausayi ne a ce duniya gaba ɗaya an rufe ta ana fama da annoba, amma har yanzu waɗansu suna gani abu mai sauƙi su je su tayar a wani gari su yi kisan kai ba dalili. Har yanzu a cikin wannan waɗansu a cikin sunan addini ko siyasa ko ƙabila za su je su kayar ma waɗansu har da zubar da jini. Wannan abin tausayi ne. Ina kira ga gwamnati da dukkan jama'ar Najeriya, wannan lokaci ya kamata mu tausaya wa juna mu kuma ci gaba da neman duk hanyoyi na kawo zaman lafiya. Now let me come back to our text. In our text this morning, we are told Christ is risen. Christ is risen. How did it all happen? We know the story. On Good Friday, the story ended with utter silence after Jesus was crucified, after he died, and after he was laid to rest. For a moment, it was all silent, and Jesus seemed to have been defeated, and the enemy seemed to have triumphed. All hope seemed to have ended. But this all changed on Sunday morning when Mary, three women, all of them, Mary, the mother of Jesus, Mary Magdalene, and Mary Salome, went to the tomb where Jesus was laid on Friday. They went with the purpose to anoint his body according to tradition, which was not done because of the Sabbath. When they went to the tomb, they were sure to find his body. They were sure they would see his dead body. You don't go to a tomb to visit a person that is alive. You don't need to go to a mortuary to visit a person that is alive. So all you can find is a dead body. And they were sure they would find his body. Except there was one obstacle. That is the big and huge stone that was rolled to cover the tomb. But then they were worried as they went. This was a big obstacle. How could they overcome it? To their surprise, the stone had been rolled back, the tomb was open, and it was empty. Hear the voice of the enemy. Don't be afraid. You are looking for Jesus, the Nazarene, who was crucified, he has risen. He is not here. Hallelujah. This, dear brothers and sisters, changed instantly the lives of the women, the lives of the disciples, and the lives of the church and the history of the world forever. Nothing remained the same. But then we have to raise the question, what does it mean to hear these words that he is risen? What does it mean for us that Christ is risen, especially in the midst of numerous challenges that we are facing today? In the first place, let us remember that Christ's resurrection means that death has been overcome. In other words, death itself has died. The tomb does not have any good message. It represents the end of history for every human being. And for those of us who are clergy, we know very well that the hardest moment during a funeral service is that moment where we have to put the body in the grave and say, from dust to dust, but to dust we shall rise. This is the difficult moment. So death is a threat to all of us. The Holy Bible teaches that God created the world that will reflect his glory. From the beginning, in the book of Genesis, Bible teaches us very clearly that God created the world for fellowship. But our first two parents, Adam and Eve, they disobeyed God and they sinned. This broke the perfect will of God and the plan of God for a perfect relationship with humanity. Consequently, Romans chapter 3:23 declares all of us as sinners, for all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. Because of the fingerprints of sin that started with Adam and Eve, all have sinned and falling short of the glory of God. So no one is righteous before God. And none of us has the capacity to redeem ourselves from the power of sin and death. And yet, we can see the fingerprints of sin in all aspects of life. We can see it in broken relationships that leads to so many broken hearts. We can see it in lies and deceit. We can see it in violence and murder, hate and domestic abuse, and in injustice. And yes, as we saw in the life of Pilate on Friday, we can also see the fingerprint of sin in our inability to take side for the truth and to stand for the truth. Pilate knew the truth that Jesus was not guilty, but he opted to stand with deceit and lies for the sake of his position. So also many of us today, we find ourselves in a situation where we are not able to stand for the truth, for the sake of our political position, for the sake of our ethnic position in our communities, for the sake and fear of the crowd. This is all a fingerprint of the sin that started with Adam and Eve. But God himself decided to change the ugly history of humanity through his son Jesus Christ. Those who believe in Jesus have eternal life. Listen to Jesus' words. I am the resurrection and the life. The one who believes in me will live, even though they die. And whoever lives by me, by believing in me, will never die. John 11:25-26. Dear friends, this promise was fulfilled on this Easter morning, giving humanity a new future. So he is risen. He is risen is a declaration of victory over the powers We are set free from the last enemy. For this reason, the Apostle Paul declares in 1 Corinthians 15, when he is mocking death, all death has been swallowed up in victory. All death, where is your victory? All death, where is your sting? The sting of death is sin, and the power of sin is the law. But thanks be to God. He gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Dear friends, we are free. We are free. We are free. That is who we are. So, the resurrection message is a message of victory. Second, Christ's victory over sin and death is the only hope that has kept disciples from unwavering in their faith until now. It is this message of the resurrection that has accompanied the church from the beginning until today. And it is this message that will continue to accompany us all the days of our life. Yes, it is this hope that will carry us through these confusing and godless times. And we must cling to this hope. The death of Christ gives us the assurance that he is alive and he is present today. He is everywhere. He is with us in all circumstances. He is with you. He is with you. Sometimes it is very difficult to sense how God is with us. When you are having to struggle with family problems, when you are having to struggle with ill health and the cure doesn't seem to be at sight, when you are having to struggle with families not able to feed themselves, when you are having to struggle with lack of peace and security, we sometimes are tempted to wonder, how is God present with us? It is difficult to see. It is difficult to see when you are in any way, any difficulties that believe that affect humanity. But dear friends, this morning, when you are in such condition that you begin to doubt God, remember Christ, remember his victory, remember his power, remember there is no situation that Christ hasn't already been. If it is rejection, he has been there. If it is denial, he has been there. If it is scourging and beating and insult, he has been there. If it is false prophecy, a testimony against you, he has been there. If it is death, he has been there. Yes, even when your life is at stake, remember Jesus was there. And at the end of the day, your death has been swallowed. Dear friends, I don't know what tombs you carry in your life, but certainly each one of us is encountering and carrying his or her own tomb every day. Every day, we carry the sign of tombs in our lives. But in Christ, those tombs are empty. They are powerless. No tomb has any power on the Son of God in Christ Jesus. So don't be afraid. Don't be afraid. Let our faith not be shaken, and let us never give up hope, even in the face of a deadly virus. This moment will come to pass. By the grace of God, it will come to pass. So don't be afraid. Don't be afraid even in the face of forces of darkness that seek to undermine our faith and dignity of all humanity. Let us not be afraid. Let us face it with courage, because Christ has overcome. Finally, the resurrection of Jesus is a calling and a task. We are not set free for the sake of ourselves only. God did not redeem us from the power of sin and death just for the sake of ourselves. Salvation in Christ can never be hoarded.
It is never meant to be kept somewhere. It is meant to be shared. So when we celebrate Easter, we should also remember that it is a celebration of our sending into the world. We are called to live in newness of life. We are called to continue to battle the powers of sin and darkness that continue to torment humanity, only to be eliminated in the last day. Martin Luther, in his teaching, makes very clear in expanding this text, Mark chapter 16, says, yes, death has been overcome, sin has been overcome, but its sting, its power, its force, it continues. It continues to linger around in many ways, because when we gather, we are still a bunch of human beings. So we will continue to wrestle. We will continue to battle with the power of sin and the power of darkness so long as we live, but we do so in the power and hope of the resurrection. Therefore, let us go with courage and be the witness. The world is sick. Nigeria is sick. Our communities are sick. Churches are sick. Religious organizations are sick. We are all sick. Even those who are called to preach, we tend to preach for our selfish ends. We are sick. We need to rise up with courage to stand for the light, for the gospel. To stand against hatred, against corruption that we are singing about all the time, but which has refused to go away. It has refused to go away because we are not ready to sacrifice. We cannot deal with corruption until the time that we are ready to sacrifice. But as long as our selfish ambitions take charge, we will never overcome corruption. The government can put all of us in jail because the corruption is in our hearts. It is in our spirit. It is in our souls. It is the old sin that continues to ravage us. We need the power of the gospel to liberate us. We need to confront violence and pain. We need to confront sickness and despair. And while teaching Christy, I want to run so mutuna chewa, one mutu are cash in Jesus Christi after she have poor good out. The fine cash in Jesus that I want to do, Nasara and even Zurupi the mutua. Musa ni chewa ni tati wa itali ya kuwa ya Allah ya halichidunia batikida mungu taka manye batikida Allah ya halichidunia maitawa domina wakaka usunasa ama ni tati wa itali ya kuwa ya sabini da reshi biyaya adamu da hawa kutunda fari ya magana Allah ya usa da dukshiri na Allah ya zulubi ya shigo dunia wala ni zulubi shire yeke mulki akanta Adam Shekara hapa shekono. Roma wa soko kwa ya shumika kupeche. Duka mungu zumbi mukasa kakaraja kala. Senda ala da kansa ya ala uki mataki tau mukasa Yesu Christi. Ya zume ya kadamu. Sabini da haka ni Yesu da kansa eche nine kashi matatu nine rai. Duwa neke vada kasi ya kareli. Zashi na yu. Oya uki. Kumalwane ni vana kasi ya kareli baadhe kitana na mtu wa baka wana shina alikuwa nita Allah ya ino alikuwa nita katika rana isa rana Yesu ina kasi ya kama kasi Yesu ina kama tatu ikrani ina nasa kwa zulubi na mtu wa sabura hapa bulu shumando ya na wa mtu wa ele kwa nita kufari sura shabia waya hafita mtu wa hafita shida ndiye chewa au hali ya mtu wa anasate mtu wa mata mtu iko mtu wa takare ya mtu wa na iko na nasate ya mtu wa na iko iko mtu wa zulubile haka nani yete ama godiaga Allah wande yete babu nasara kawo nasa Yesu Christu hati mtu wa masoka sana. kawo tashi Yesu kun masu kasa abu na biyu tashi Yesu daga makatu yana ba mu tabbaci cewa ba wani abu rayuwa a duniyar nan da zai yi kafi kamar yadda kafari bai yi da Yesu ba ba wani mahaluki abu a duniyar nan ko ciwo ko zafi ko kiyaye da zai yi kafi kafi ne Allah yana tare da wani lokaci idan damuwa ta kafi mutum ko a cikin iyali ko sanadiyar cuta kukan kai ga gatuwa kamar Allah baya tare da amma lokacin da zafin rayuwa ya kai ka har ka fara tunani kamar Allah baya tare da kai ka tuna da Yesu ka tuna da Yesu babu yanayi wanda za ka shiga ciki da bai shiga ciki ba ya riga ya shiga ciki ya fita nasa wai ne yake ma ka da Yesu haka kan mu ma kan ma ne kada mu tsoro iko zulubi da mutuwa kada mu tsoro kaburbura wanda muke da su namu kaburbura suna da yawa kaburbura mu shi ne da amma da muke da shi yau da kullum kaburbura mu shi ne iko zulubi wanda yake da mu kullum amma ne ta yi da kike ce kada ka tsoro gobe ka bari ba ya yi kada mu tsoro ko a fuskar annoba da wahala mu yi tafiya da ba gaskiya cewa Kristi wanda ya yi nasara zai yi mata a ƙarshe ne kuwa tashi Yesu daga matattu aiki ne na waya ne kira ne aka ba mu ana kira mu mu yi rayuwa cikin sabon rai ana kira mu mu ci gaba da kokowa da ikon zunubi da muke gani a duniya da duhu kada mu tsorata kada mu farka mu yi fargaba wajen sailan wannan albishirin ya tashi ba shi nan ya tashi ba shi nan ya tashi wannan shi ne wanda ya karfafa almajirai tun da fari wannan kuma shi ne zai karfafa mu a yanzu da kwanaki masu zuwa ƴan uwa mu tsaya da ƙarfin hali a cikin wannan duniya na ƙiyayya na mugunta na zalunci da kisan kai shi wanda ya tashi yana gaban mu zuwa gare mu the risen Christ goes ahead of us into Galilee he is risen hallelujah amen we are one